We go on to the next match, Io Sky versus Bianca Belair in the WWE Women's Title match. What are your thoughts on this one?
I zoned out on this. I'll be honest. Bianca, I really like. I was so over this by the missus looked at me and she goes, Jesus Christ, is half this show women's matches? And I don't know, just the ones when you're bored.
Right.
Just the ones where when you're already checked out, you look up and you go, oh, it's the girls in the ring. Great. No, I mean, I love Bianca and I love Io too, but this is just, once again, too much bad timing. And also at the same time too, it's like, here's bad girl Kairi Sane.
Well, we'll,
like,
we'll get to that. I mean, cares, overall, you know? I kind of agree with you on that for different reasons. I thought the match wasn't bad. There was absolutely some misses by Io Sky, you know, the missed missile drop kick and stuff like that. Like, there was different points where the match wasn't gelling too well, but both of them, you know, for the most part had a solid match. It was good, but you could almost tell, I felt like the feud wasn't built up enough for them to go at it as hard as they could. Does that make sense? Like, this is a transitional match. Even though it was a title match, it felt completely transitional. Kairi Sane showing up with her new makeup and her evil look. I saw that people were losing their fucking minds for it, and good for them that you enjoy it. But I think people forget that Kairi Sane is a China doll. She is a ceramic doll and she gets injured easily. As long as they keep her protected, as long as they keep her in situations away from Nia Jax, away from Charlotte, away from anybody else that's a little stiffer than normal, I think she'll shine just fine. And I'm glad they got her away from the pirate gimmick. The pirate gimmick, I know that was a thing that she did in Japan in a way too, but I'm just not a fan of the "Yar, I'm a Japanese schoolgirl." You know, it doesn't do it for me. But yeah, she's a talented performer. She's just very breakable. And, you know, hopefully they do something with her and Io. Obviously, they planted the seeds in this match too, that Bayley has no idea why Kairi is here. So it's one of those things that it might be the Asian invasion kind of thing too. Bayley's going to get pushed out. Bayley and Dakota are going to get pushed out. So.
Oh my God. PWI 250 readers are just punching the air right now. This WWE takes all their favorite dollies away. Yeah. No, I don't know. I don't give a shit about this stuff. It doesn't resonate with me. I like some of the players, but you know, just another small girl wearing a skirt and cosplay bullshit. I don't care. Right. I just don't care. You know, like when I'm looking at, I'm seeing Rhea, Raquel, and like actual women that look like they could hurt people. I don't need any more little cheerleaders. I'm all set. Well,
that's
I
the get problem. It. They love their cheerleaders. Like even Liv Morgan, like there's a lot. Alexa Bliss back in the day. They love the cheerleader girls.
I'm having trouble doing this.
Shut up, you. I literally bring her name up once a fucking year and you got to sit there and scream at me. Oh my God. Anyway,
well, there she is.
Didn't quite catch that.
Ugh.
Call me again.
No. God damn it. But yeah, they love their cheerleaders, man. And so I totally agree with you. You look at the fucking Haas of women that you have on the roster and you see somebody like Kairi. I think the only reason that they're doing that is because of those fans of Joshi Wrestling, that they want this girl in there. But the problem is she's not a threat. She doesn't seem like a threat in any way. It's not a superior wrestling. I'm just going to go on record and say it. Joshi Wrestling is not superior, especially in 2023, is not superior to what women's wrestling is in America. What is expected of bigger, stronger, more athletic women of in not just in America, in North America, the whole fucking place. You know, even a lot of the Mexican women that are wrestling and stuff are thicker and bigger and just have, you know what I mean, more of a staunch to them. Where they're believable. Not all, of course. There's always going to be tiny fucking women out there for the most part. But it's like, I don't know. I mean, unless they're bringing in Aja Kong, you know, like, what are you going to do? What are you going to show me that Kairi's going to be able to do, that she's going to look menacing against Charlotte Flair, that she's going to look menacing against, I don't know, half these women.
Who are you to doubt Gianna, the second greatest wrestler in the world?
I know.
Julia Gulia.
Yes.
Yeah. How do you talk down to these girls, Mish? Yeah. What? No. This is.
I mean, you're going to give me Kairi Sane or Masha Slamovich.
Right. Right. You know? This is how I explain it to the people that love that stardom shit at this point. Okay. There's some people who spend a lot of money to look at a chick's feet. All right. Wow. And that's for you. I'm not saying it's not. Yeah. I'm not saying it's the worst thing. Some of us enjoy boobies. Some of us enjoy big old fat asses. Some enjoy both. And some people just love arch support. And you're like, oh, arches. Like,
Dr. Scholes, baby. All right.
Oh, yeah. Look at that arch. Like, they're into that.
Yeah, Sarah Logan. Fine. You're right there, Oki. Oki brings up Sarah Logan. Perfect arch support on Sarah Logan. I agree.
Look at that arch support. Yeah, no, that's for you. And that's your fetish. And that's what gets you dinky hard. And that's fine.
Right.
But what gets your dinky hard isn't meant for everybody. Well, just like the foot fetish, you know, like some people, like there's a reason why, you know, Scarlett Johansson is in a movie and we see her, you know, her giant ass and her nice tits and not her fucking cuticles.
Right.
Or her fucking toesies. Like, right. That's for you. That's your little fetish and that's fine. But the rest of us don't have to buy into it, you know?
Yep. No, for sure. And the other last observation of this match before we move on was the fact that Michael Cole was letting us know that it was Kairi Sane's last match with Bayley, Bayley was her last match. So maybe there's some kind of comeuppance there with Kairi and Sky being together and then turning on Bayley. So throwing that out there.
Follow WrestlingSoup on Twitter at WrestlingSoup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. No. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.